It could be said that Planned Parenthood is following the lead of so-called big box stores. With abortions on the decline and a difficult economy, it's shifting from small neighborhood clinics to supersized regional facilities like this one in Florida. It joins an Illinois location and a 40,000 square foot building in Denver, all opened in just the last 3 years.
But the Houston Supercenter is the largest. It stands 6 stories tall and offers 78,000 square feet of space. And pro-lifers here fear it will dramatically increase the number of abortions.
Planned Parenthood isn't investing this kind of money in order to do less business.
Father Martin serves at the Catholic Charismatic Center just across the Gulf Freeway from the new clinic. He's one of the leaders who opposed this expansion from the start. So why Houston and why the supercenters? In short,
it is such a lucrative business. They are going to be charging anywhere from $500 to maybe $2,500 per abortion procedure.
Abby Johnson should know. Johnson made headlines last year when she quit her job as director of the Planned Parenthood Clinic in Bryan, Texas, after watching an ultrasound of an abortion. She points out that the new Houston facility will have an entire floor dedicated to abortions.
They have somewhere around 5 exam rooms and 2 operating rooms so that they can do late-term abortion procedures.
In public statements, Planned Parenthood downplays its abortion services at the new supercenter. It's a common theme, one that came out in a CBN interview with President Cecile Richards last year.
Planned Parenthood, we see 3 million plus patients a year. 97% of the health care that we deliver is preventive health care.
But the money trail shows abortion, while a small percent of overall business provides a big chunk of revenue. Jim Sedlak at the American Life League analyzed a recent annual report. He found abortions make up 37% of clinic income.
It is the highest priced item that they sell.
Current trends make it likely the Houston Supercenter will easily expand its abortion business. The metro area is one of the most rapidly growing urban centers in the country. And the new facility sits right in the middle of Latino and African American neighborhoods. Research shows minority groups have the highest abortion rates. The University of Houston and Texas Southern University are nearby as well.
There's a lot of poverty, there's a lot of college students, a lot of people who are going to fit the profile of who Planned Parenthood is going to go after.
Planned Parenthood has responded to the charge that it's targeting minorities. It says the new location right off the freeway provides easy access. And a public statement notes, nearly 1 million residents of Harris County lack health insurance, and nearly half are of reproductive age. But Johnson says Planned Parenthood's Promotora program, an outreach to Latinos, shows its plans are clear.
They intentionally go into those neighborhoods and say, you don't have to worry about it. You can come in. We're not going to report you. This is a safe place to go. They never talk about abortions, but that's the hook. Just to get them in the door so that they can develop that rapport and so they can then tell them, you know, if you want birth control, we can provide that for you for free. And if you ever find yourself in a situation where you have an unintended pregnancy, we can help you with that too.
Houston's faith community has opposed the supercenter from the beginning. It has organized construction boycotts and prayer vigils, including a massive rally on Martin Luther King Day. That drew major evangelical leaders and national media attention. Dave Welch, head of the Houston Area Pastors Council, wants city government to enforce current abortion restrictions and create new ones.
What we're looking at is trying to make it as unprofitable as possible for Planned Parenthood to take the lives of innocent unborn children. It's a horrendous thing to even say that, but we know it to be true.
Pro-lifers plan to maintain an ongoing physical presence at the clinic.
We hope to be here every hour that they're open in prayer and offering of alternatives.
After years on the inside, Johnson is now a fierce advocate for those prayers on the outside.
What happens is that when the workers are going in and when the women are going in, it is pricking their conscience. And they're having to really think, wow, somebody's holding me accountable for this choice. These people out here that are praying for me, they know what I'm doing.
What Houston has been doing is more than 8,000 abortions a year. This supercenter is a fresh reminder of plans to drive those numbers up and whether the Houston community will demand not in our backyard. Reporting in Houston, Heather Sells, CBN News.